In 1994, I mean, born and brought up in Mumbai, I was in movement and then met my husband, who is a farmer, and taught for 1 year in Mumbai, and then I shifted to a village called Masward in Satara district with my husband. And working with women, one woman came and she said that, I want to open a saving account, and banks are not opening my account. I felt it's such a simple thing. So I took her to all the banks to open a saving account. And bank said that, no, she's not a viable customer for us because she would save not more than 5 rupees. Second thing she said was that I want to save every day. So not a single bank. In spite, in my village, there were 5 banks, commercial and nationalized bank. They did not open her account. Then the idea came, why not start a bank? And that's how we started a women's bank. So the real challenge starts now. How you start a women's bank? I went to Reserve Bank of India, but globally you say Federal Reserve. Reserve Bank of India, that how would you start? So private bank, 1,000 crores, no, not possible. Then cooperative bank, very difficult. Dual control, cooperative department, state, corruption, what ethics for discussion. Ethics doesn't exist there. So then, but anyway, we applied. When we applied for the banking license, all our promoting members were non-literate. And then on that ground, Reserve Bank of India rejected the license, saying that how can we issue a license to the bank whose promoting members are totally non-literate? License was rejected. From Mumbai, I came crying to my village. I talked to women. They didn't cry. They said, so what? We'll conduct the classes and we'll learn to read and write. I realized I am not used to rejections. They are used to rejections. So they were again ready. We conducted the classes for 4 months, 5 months, I think, then applied again. At that time, women, I thought, they are more confident than me, so women accompanied me to Reserve Bank of India. We had taken an appointment from CGM. That is an institution who actually at least follows their commitment. If they commit, they take time to commit. But if they commit, Reserve Bank of India, they at least follow. So then we were, blocked, but we went into the room of CGM, started a discussion. I wasn't sure what women are going to say, but they said that you have rejected the license because we cannot calculate, we are non-literate. But when we were growing, there were no schools in my village. So we are not responsible for our non-literacy and non-education. Then they said that tell us to calculate the interest of any principal amount. If we fail, don't issue the license. But tell your officers to calculate the interest of principal amount without calculator and see who can calculate faster. I had no idea how much confidence these women had. Anyway, so who are these women? I would request Ashavari to play a Kantabai story. She was the first.
We're a Katrajad Kitty, Putuli Bagaja. Sakari care louder than Satos, that the Hawaii Pretty is Punchiska.
Take a big time on
the other. Get
the love, Pandra Rupa, Vara Rupa.
Take
me, take me, take me, take me, take me, take me, take me, take me, take me, take me, take me, take me, take me, take me, take me, take me, take me, take
This is Kantabai. These these are the women who bank with Mandeshi. And when we started the bank, the challenge was what would be the product. So women like Kantabai, they would say, we cannot come to the bank because we lose our working day. There is a transportation cost. So bank started, if women cannot come to the bank will go to them. So then bank started doorstep banking. I would not go into technicalities of those details, but what I'm trying to say is that if you want to reach these women, these clients, do a business with them, listen to them, they have much more to offer, and then you can be successful. So those banks were thinking that her account is not viable. In 2000, Mandeshi was able to make a profit from such clients. Today we have 180,000 women banking with Mandeshi. And I would also like to add that when I talk about financial inclusion at Reserve Bank of India and all those buzzwords, mainstream banking keep telling that, you know, banks are, we open the account, but there is no transaction in these banks. We open the zero balance account, such a below dignity term, zero balance account. Oh my God. And our women, and they say that they don't do transactions, but our women do transactions every day, more than 300 transactions a day. I just don't know why that is not happening with the mainstream banking sector. There's need to rethink for what you are, if you want to do the business. If you don't, it's fine.